Well, welcome to This Week at CBN. I want to share a little meditation I had the other day about the need for us as Christians to reach out to people, to go to where they are and let them know that God loves them and He wants to receive them. Here's the passage. It's from Luke chapter 15. Then all the tax collectors and the sinners drew near to Him to hear Him. And the Pharisees and the scribes complained, saying, "This man receives sinners and eats with them." Now, let's not be Pharisees in our culture today. You know, you can sometimes fall into a temptation to say, I can't associate with people because of their life and what they're doing. That's not what Jesus did. He went to them. He ate with them. And the amazing thing is they gladly heard His words. They wanted to hear that they could have life again, that they could be forgiven, and that they could be loved by a merciful God. That's what we need to be doing. Because when Jesus heard what the Pharisees were saying, well, He gave them a parable. It's in the same chapter in Luke, chapter 15. "Or what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one coin, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she has found it, she calls her friends and neighbors together, saying, 'Rejoice with me, for I have found the peace which I lost.' Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents." Realize there's joy in heaven over just one. And if we spend a lifetime trying to reach out to others who haven't heard the good news, who need to know that they can be forgiven, then we can have that same joy, and we'll have that joy with the angels in heaven. Start thinking about heaven. Start thinking about what do you take with you. I think you already know all your money's not going to go. Your house isn't going to go with you. Your car isn't going to go with you. The only thing that you get to take with you in heaven is people. And the people that you witness to, the people that you disciple. The Apostle Paul said, "You're my crown. You know, you're my reward. Because when I get to heaven, I'm going to enjoy being with you." That should occupy our thoughts, and that should be what we are constantly about. Here's a translation from 1 Timothy chapter 2. This is the New Living Translation, a little bit different from the Greek, but I love the words. "I urge you, first of all, to pray for all people as you make your requests. Plead for God's mercy upon them and give thanks." Start thinking about people that you know who don't know the Lord. And start praying for them, and start pleading for God's mercy to fall upon them. Start praying for opportunities to share a word in love, to share the good news. Start praying even for people in other countries. You know, when I lived in Manila, I had all these prayer maps, and I'd pray over the nations. I'd pray over India, pray over Indonesia, I'd pray over China, pray over specific cities. Do that. Let's pray over the Middle East, the great turmoil that's there now. Pray that God's mercy would find them, that they would find the Prince of Peace, that He would appear to them in visions and dreams, and they would know the true God. They would know Jesus as the Savior, the one sent to forgive them of all their sins. Let's start praying that God's mercy would fall. That's it for This Week at CBN. God bless you.